When you see the warning that says power reduced to lower engine temp in your Ford vehicle, in the ideal world, it means that your car just activated limp mode and it lowered the power of your engine to let your engine cool down because the engine is overheated and the sensors in your cooling system register that the temperature of the coolant is too high. So you may need to check anything that can cause engine overheating, maybe anything like the thermostats, the water pump, it may be the problems with the coolant, maybe the coolant level is low. You need to check all these cases, especially if you have a simple engine, not power boost, not hybrid engine. But you will most likely see this warning in the power boost engine. This is the hybrid EcoBoost engine, and it's mostly used in the F-150 model. And this message in this vehicle means that there is a problem with the exhaust heat exchanger. Like in 90% of cases, you will have the problem with the exhaust heat exchanger, which is a plastic valve that is located inside the exhaust pipes of your car. And it's a very bad piece of engineering by Ford that has two major problems. It keeps leaking all the time, and all the owners of PowerBoost have this leaking problem sooner or later. And the second problem, it solved this error saying power reduced to lower engine temp. So there is a separate sensor that registers temperature in that heat exchanger, and it's very often faulty. The sensor is faulty, or the heat exchanger is stuck, so this plastic valve may get stuck. And in this case, you will see this message all the time. It doesn't affect the engine, because in most cases the coolant temperature is not higher in the engine, but it may be higher in this heat exchanger. Why did they make this heat exchanger? Exhaust heat exchanger exists to warm up the air in your cabin faster than it would warm up if this heat exchanger wasn't used. So it's actually the comfort feature. Ford had a lot of problems with this feature, with this heat exchanger, and they didn't make a recall yet. But what they did, they produced a special part that can help you eliminate that heat exchanger from the cooling cycle. And this part cost $5. This is the plastic tube that just substitutes that heat exchanger, and it's official Ford part, and I will leave the number of that part in the description so you can buy it. Alternatively, you can replace the exhaust heat exchanger, which costs some money, and it's also not that easy to replace, so it will also take some money for labor. But the problem is that even new heat exchangers, exhaust heat exchangers, they are not perfect, and they keep falling apart, and they keep getting stuck, and they keep giving you this error message and several types of error codes.